Vasvi Bharatram, Joint Vice President of the Shriram Schools and also a member of the board of Save the Children, is now with us. Vasvi, good to have you on the show. The importance, so you're associated with Save the Children. At the same time, you are the Vice Chairman, Joint Vice Chairman of Shriram Schools. I want to know your experiences with children, especially in this period of lockdown.
Thank you, and I'd like to say many congratulations to NDTV to take up this program, this very, very important issue. Children all over, the lives of children all over come to a standstill thanks to this pandemic. Very regular children in metros who are struggling with online courses, their teachers having to read, unlearn, and do something different. Or it's children who don't have any facilities at the best of times, children whose homes may be displaced because they belong to a migrant community, they don't have access to education, their parents have lost their livelihoods, and they are facing all kinds of issues. And they're also not able to do any kind of social distancing because maybe there is just not an option in the living conditions that they are in. Children all over are suffering, and it is up to us to do something about it. The main needs of any child, identity, which I say the children is doing a great job in getting Aadhaar card for many, many children. It is basic health and education. And of course, it is safety and security where they are. In terms of education, as many people before me have said, there has been a huge disruption. Regular schooling has come to an absolute halt. Schools were havens for children where they would at least get time on their own for a few hours. They would interact with their peers. It was a place of learning, and it was also a place which ensured that they got at least one square meal a day. And now all that is disrupted, and there is no knowing when it all starts again. In the meantime, as people are taking food, medicines, and masks and sanitizers, we should all think about what else we can take to these children, which could be education kits, which could be game activity, anything to keep education going. Because as we know, once it opens up, this is going to be a huge challenge for our country to get children back on track, back into their schools.
Do you know one thing I was meaning to ask you, Vasvi, before my colleague Anjali asked her question? See, you read books about the time of India post-independence, how India was taking care of the refugees who had come. They had huge problems in their lives. But then the Indian government decided that the best thing that is going to work is distraction. So there were these mobile vans where movie was shown. Now, it did not offer great solution, but it distracted the mind and thus brought in some comfort in their lives. Do you think that for all these homeless children, something similar could be tried?
Definitely. I think anything that we try, this is a good initiative because it will keep them engaged, it will keep them learning, it will keep them from getting into opportunities of danger and of mischief. So I feel anything that we can try which can engage them and keep them distracted and learning is all towards help.
Right. Vasvi, what about post-COVID world? What will happen to these children? Do you think, as far as especially education, will they fall too far behind because of this lockdown?
It is a huge concern. It's going to be a big challenge for the government and for all the various NGOs who are involved in education. But this is India, and we have known to be survivors. We've known to be any kind of calamity, and we come together and quite sure that we find a solution. Though there will be challenges, like children may be in a different geographical area from where they started, so they might have to look for new schools. Their parents may have lost their livelihood, so they may not really encourage them to go back to school and actually encourage them to take up a job.
Right.
There could be big gaps in their learning for which the government will have to make a lot of effort to support them. But right now, the whole education community is in a bit of a flux because nobody knows what's happening. The board exams got disrupted. Nobody knows how the university admissions are going to happen, how the competitive exams are going to be held. So everything right now is just wait and watch and see. But I totally believe the power of Indians, and I know that we will come through and deal with whatever happens.
Thank you. Thank you, Vasvi. We really do hope that gap is not that big that it cannot be filled and that the children cannot catch up later. Thank you so much.
Aur ab hamare saath, that every to each one of us to help fill the gap in whichever way we can. And whatever little bit we can do, we must. Thank you.
Thank you.